You were. But we should have she did a finish. Meaning, what did your parents leave you? Mm-hmm. Eh? I'm suffering for your sake. Eh? I don't know what you'll be in future.
Maybe a thief.
And you'll be a thief.
Clara here again, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Again today, I'm very happy to have Mr. Kambanji with us. If you remember last time, we talked about forgiveness and we learned a lot of things, and I thought that I should bring him back again so that we can talk about something very interesting again. Yeah, so Mr. Kambanji, welcome back to the program.
Thank you very much. I'm humbled.
Yeah, so today the reason why I've called you is I want us to talk about gifts. The God-given gift. Start with what I can ask you is, how can you discover that you've got this certain gift? For example, singing, dancing, in those lines, how can you discover that? Or maybe you can also relate it to your life, I mean, how you discovered your gift.
Thank you very much. We are all created in the image of God. Mm-hmm. And God has made us in his creation to be unique. Mm-hmm. And in this uniqueness, he has put a gift of life in each one of us.
Okay.
Now, when do you discover it?
Yes.
In my view, I think it's something that you begin to display when you are a child. Mm-hmm. For example, girls would start mimicking what their mothers do in the kitchen, you know, try to cook, try to do this, and maybe they'll try to do something extraordinary that all the other girls are not doing. For example, she'll be knitting, you know. She'll get a stick, she'll get leaves, and then start joining leaves, you know. And if she continues to do that every often, then you deduce that, oh, I think that's her gift. Then there are those that want to sing. You know, when they are busy cooking or washing, they'll be singing a choir song, or singing some song from school, or this and that. Again, you identify that at an early stage. In my case, I was good at memorizing Bible verses in Sunday school. Mm-hmm. And because of that, the teacher will ask me to help with the slow learners. Mm-hmm. And I developed that passion to help the slow learners.
Okay.
And hence now, it's there. Mm-hmm. I help people.
Okay.
I help my students.
Mm-hmm.
I would love to help.
So that's your gift. Yeah. And again, you know, I've noticed that, like, here in Zambia, I don't know if it's a Zambian thing or it's an African thing, I've noticed that gifts like maybe singing or dancing are never appreciated. Let's say, for example, maybe here is a child who has maybe, she or he has done well at school, maybe having very good marks, and then they want to go into dancing or singing or acting or modeling. And here comes a parent who says, that's a sheer waste of time. You need to at least become a doctor or something that can give you a lot of money at the end of the day. What can you advise some parents on that one? How can parents guide their children to do, to become who they want to become? Yeah.
I'll start by giving you a story. You live in the neighborhood of Musonda and Kapoto. Now, some years ago, there used to be two neighbors, childhood friends, Wadia and Banda. They were orphans, being kept by their widowed grandmother. Okay. Now, Boadia's grandmother would say to Boadia, "Hey Boadia, go and do this, go and do clean this, go do this. Do some household chores, and then before you go to school." In the meantime, Piri's grandmother would say, "Oh, boil some water, have a bath. In the meantime, I'll prepare you something to take to school." Mm-hmm. It wasn't much. But there was something. Okay. The other boy, Boadia, would say, "But grandma, what do I take to school?" The grandma would say, "Chipwawu iwe, ba wishiba bishiride finish." Meaning, what did your parents leave you? Mm-hmm. Eh? I'm suffering for your sake. Eh? I don't know what you've been in future. Kafe kabora.
You'll be a thief.
And every day, Boadia went through that ordeal.
Yeah.
Piri would be encouraged by the grandmother.
Yeah.
"No, wake up. I want you to be a doctor." You know, last time when you were sick, went to Kitwe General or Central Hospital, there was that doctor who attended to you. Mm-hmm. He's still young. So I want you to be like that, a doctor. Mm-hmm. So these boys grew up. They went to Valley View, from Valley View Primary School, they went to Kitwe Boys. From Kitwe Boys, Boadia dropped out. He could not even go past grade 9 because the grandmother was discouraging her. He instead became a thief. Piri went to Unza and he became a doctor.
It's like what the grandmother said.
Yes.
Came through, yeah.
Now, I am saying to fellow parents, the destiny of your children partly lies in your hands. The way you care for them, the way you support them. And also, the way you talk to them. What comes out of your mouth? If it is a negative saying, it will become the norm. and the child will grow to accept it as a norm. But when you speak positively, you follow it with positive actions, the child will grow positively to be what you want them to be. Okay. Now, my own experience was because I was good in at Sunday school.
That's how I was coming to that, yeah.
At Sunday school, my parents would encourage me to sit by my fellow children to help them memorize the verses, to teach them at an early stage. Even when I started primary school, the teachers exposed me to the same situation where I would be asked to go and help be an aid teacher in a lower grade where the teacher hadn't shown up or the teacher was late. And I grew up to enjoy teaching.
Okay.
Hence, finally, I had to teach at CBU.
Okay. And you enjoy it?
Yes.
Because that's who you are.